The following is a presentation of E60 Pictures.
Alright, here it is. The old book. Trying to write promos for the night, trying to come up with ideas, anything that can help. Hello. Hello, my name is Tyler Breeze. In case you're wondering, of course I'm a model. It's not a matter. 3, 2. Hi. My name is Tyler Breeze. In case you're wondering, of course I'm a model. I'm Matt Clement, aka Tyler Breeze.
Matt Clement grew up in a small town in Western Canada. He grew up playing hockey, but he always dreamed of becoming a pro wrestler. After a short independent career, he was signed by WWE's NXT in 2010 at the age of 22.
Look at this blonde hair on this guy. This mustache on me.
Wow.
Dirty.
Very good.
Right away, Clement became friends with fellow wrestler Austin Watson, better known as Xavier Woods. The duo became a tag team, and later roommates.
Pretty interesting there, Woods.
Mike Dalton!
The first character he played in WWE developmental was Mike Dalton.
Looks like Dalton's turn. Nice back elbow there. Again, Dalton. Nice reversal.
Basically, it was kind of a crossroads for me. It was, you know, I've been here, I think I was 2 years at that point. I was going out there and I was having good matches, but for some reason, the fans just didn't have that kind of something to sink their teeth into. And I actually had a conversation with Triple H, and he just said, you know, you gotta be different. You gotta do everything possible to differentiate yourself from the people on the other side of that railing. And I just had to, you know, take a step back and just really kind of look at who I was, who Mike Dalton was. And, you know, if it's not working, then you gotta change it up.
In January 2013, WWE told Clement his character needed a change, or he would be released. 6 months later, Clement's new character, the one that he came up with himself, was born.
Celebrities essentially can be summed up very simple. He is the most super good looking piece of gorgeousness that you're ever gonna meet. Ever. And that's it.
June 20th, 2013.
When you're looking at yourself there.
With a half year of planning behind him, Clement rehearsed his new ring entrance, using a pocket mirror as a prop.
You gotta feel that beat.
Yes.
Once you learn the music, this is, I know it's the
yeah,
first
once I get
time
in my head, then it's like, okay.
It's like even, you know, eventually when you do the tug up there, it'd be nice if you did it on that big beat. There's a big beat, but we'll follow you. You just do it. If you can do it, if not, we'll follow you with the light.
Do you like the hood on the beat or the glasses on the beat and the zoom in?
I like whatever you do. It all works, so just do it.
Use it all. You gotta use it all. You gotta come to here. You gotta use it. You gotta be Liberace, whoever that was. I mean, you gotta use it all. In real life, you're a cowboy, but use this thing as something else.
Okay, we got
to. Yeah, this is just interviewing like Matt Clement, right?
Yeah, it's just you.
Cool.
So, how many times do you do that?
I don't know, 10, 12? You lose count. Something like that. I mean, it's just go. So, it's big, especially debuting tonight. You know, eyes are on it to see, to be like, okay, you know, is it good or are we scrapping it or, you know, what's going on? So, nervous, but excited too, so.
4 hours later, it was time for Tyler Breeze to debut on NXT. This time with a more modern device, an iPhone.
It was just kind of one of those things, you know, we were running through it and just a couple people just saw it. And I think Triple H actually, it was his idea. He saw it and he just kind of said, you know, I think we're past that. I think, you know, in the world, you know, we're kind of evolving. We're always evolving. We're modernizing stuff. You know, I think the mirrors, it's been done. It's, you know, I think it's gone. Let's move on to, you know, the selfie thing I think is pretty big. And so I said, yeah, cool, works for me.
It's gonna be good. It's gonna be good.
Good.
Feeling good. Think you're gonna win?
Yeah, I think so.
Male model Fury. You know, and I know D'Angelo Dawkins wishes that he looked that good, but he's about to
he's
get
taking
a little
pictures.
More uglier. Well, he's checking his hair up, obviously.
Huge spinning heel kick.
You know, sometimes it just takes a little while for people to find their niche, right? Me, cowboy, turned into New Age Outlaw, DX member, and sometimes you just go through a couple things. That's what developmental is about. We get to try all kinds of things until we throw it, pow, and it sticks against the wall. It's all good.
It seems to be well received. Everybody seems to be positive about it. So I'm hoping, you know, that was what they were looking for, and, you know, we go from there.
Tyler Breeze. I saw Tyler in the new incarnation of his persona. To me, it was the first time I've seen him wrestle that I was interested in him as a fan. Wanting to see this kid and wanting to see what he's done, I got to throw it out to you guys, is where are we at with that? Is he getting better with it?
I think he's finally submitted to the fact of reinventing himself and then letting, you know, let the coaches guide him. And after your talk and a number of talks, he realized that it was, you know, sink or swim a little bit. So he gets better every week, and his reaction for a guy we've had on the roster for 2 years, now he's found that niche.
You think he feels the character?
Yeah, I think, and Billy, you spend, you know, he's another one of Billy's products.
He's basically pretending to be Billy.
That's what he's
The thing is he's having a lot of fun with this character, so that's
the key, right?
Turn helps, right?
That's the key. If he's digging it, then all right, cool.
Tyler Breeze is now one of the most popular draws in NXT.
Everything's fine with it. It's just bring the audience in. I mean, nobody that's ever had a great entrance didn't look at the audience at some point. You see what I'm saying, Joey?
Yeah. He did it one time, that last entrance he did, where when he got down to the bottom here, he was looking in the camera and then he looked away. You know what I mean?
Maybe it's taken me 4 years. Maybe it takes other people a year. Maybe it takes other people more. You know, everybody's different, and it just took me a little longer to kind of find it. But, you know, I feel confident in what I do now, and I think that shows, you know, in everything that I do. And, you know, there really is no deadline. I'm here, you know, for good. You know, so, you know, no deadline for me.